I'm the team lead for Zootools UK. Today I'm going to be speaking for the next 15 minutes about Zootools. Zootools is a new and innovative product, but let's focus on what is Zootools. How many times have you been in a cafe or a restaurant and you're looking for the Wi-Fi? Most of the times, if there is a Wi-Fi, you'll see that it's locked. You can start around, start asking the waiter, the bartender, what's the password. That creates a lot of hassle. It's not the best solution. Sometimes you get frustrated, sometimes you just decide to ask. Sometimes the waiter doesn't know, he's new. It's a lot of hassle, and unnecessary hassle. Zootools tries to bridge that gap. It's a device in which you give your social credentials or your email, and in return, it gives you free Wi-Fi access. Basically, it's a router that works in the existing Wi-Fi and does that. Very simple and very straightforward. So, Zootools device plus a like or a follow or your email equals Wi-Fi. Why is this good for the customer? This is good for the customer because it's very fast, very efficient. You don't have to ask anyone. In 1 minute, you're up and running the Wi-Fi. But why is it better? It's really good for the establishment. Establishment was giving you Wi-Fi and didn't get anything in return. You didn't know who you were. You were just logging in the Wi-Fi. That was it. Best case scenario, you would come back just because you had the password ready. You would prefer that place to go for a coffee. But now, what Zootools does is turns that customer into a follower, into a supporter. That customer now is a person. You have statistics, you have live statistics, when he went to the store, how long he stayed there, who is he, is he male, female, did he come back, how long has it been since the last time he came. So, the best part of it all, it's really, really, really simple. Just plug and play. It's a device, Yeti. The owner of the place has the access to the portal, statistics. The customer just logged in. No interaction, very easy, very fast, live feed. As you can see, you have the statistics, how many connections, how many likes, where they're from, where they, who are they now, how much bandwidth did they use. A bunch of information that there was no way in the past to get. In the past, you had to go on, have a survey, ask people around, put that in a database. Now Zootools does all that for you. All that for you in a very simple way for both the customer and both the establishment. Just plug it in and it works. Just works. So basically this is a product combined with a service. For the customer side, as we said, very straightforward. For the establishment side, subscription based. A few packages you can see in more detail in the website. And a lot of information. Information, information, information. Technology that merges all the information, takes the jungle, and makes it meaningful and usable information for the establishment. So, as a lot of people here want to become entrepreneurs, start their own startup, I'm going to tell you the short story of how Zootools came to be. Basically, Nikos and Nektarios, the Zootools co-founders, had the same problem. They were in a restaurant trying to log into Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi had a password, started asking around, a lot of hassle. They said there must be a better way. And they noticed that there wasn't really a better way. There were specific solutions, but there wasn't a better way. Both guys were really technical, so they said, okay, that's an idea. Let's come up with a better way. A few months later, a lot of code later, a lot of hardware research, they merged the two together. They created Zootools. So they had a really nice product. They knew the product was nice. So they started going around asking, how can we make this a company? They went to a few VCs, but they got turned down. The product was really nice, really good idea. But they were really both very technical. They needed some commercial side in the team. They needed some strategic planning in the team. So they started looking around more. That's where they found Christos. Christos was a country manager for Apple, mentoring the Open Fund. He came along, secured the funding for them, €150,000 funding, became an angel investor himself, and most importantly, brought along Nassos. Nassos was a country manager of Nokia. He became the commercial manager for Zootl. So from a very technical team, they created a very, very well-rounded team. They had the funding, so they created the company. Now that team was very skilled, so things started moving really fast. That's why I'm here in such a short amount of time. 1 month ago, they launched in Greece. In 1 month, they have more than 50 installations, including IKEA, and like the most famous central bars and restaurants, and they keep going strong. And now I'm here to lead the launch in UK. Soft launch, but still going really strong. So more or less, this is the product, these are the people, this is how from an idea it became a company, and this is how where we are now. So if I had to give one advice, that at least I got from this whole venture, is if you have an idea, don't let it stay an idea. Make it a product, put all the hours you need, put all the skills you need, just keep pushing, find the right people, never stop. When you get your idea on the ground, keep pushing some more. That's all for me.